Okay. All right now, Leo. Thank you very much. Now, from the Australian end, on their 100th countdown, we've got Supernaut, LRB, Daryl Braithwaite, Renee Geyer, John Paul Young, All 55, TMG, and Mark Holden. And what better to start off the show was a group that we introduced a long, long time ago, and it was Skyhooks with Horror Movie. Let's have a look at Horror Movie, the first time we saw Skyhooks on Countdown.
Exercise it, David. I get it out of there, guys. Ego, it's not a dirty word.
Ego,
it's not a dirty word.
Ego,
it's not a dirty word. Don't you believe what you've seen or you've heard.
Ego,
it's not a dirty
word. Well, we're proud of that, but we're even more prouder at the moment because we've finally got Skyhooks together with Bob in the band as well, and we're going to preview their new single that's not out for a couple of weeks, and it really is what it's all about. Parties to end all parties. Skyhooks! All right, now this looks a bit confusing. That was Kiki D, and she has got just a beautiful single in that one. Now listen, I've got two people here. Do you watch Countdown, mate? You do?
Yeah.
Your name's Andrew, obviously. Someone just said, yelled out, good on Andrew.
Yeah.
Where are you from, Andrew?
Bendigo.
Right up in that middle of Victoria, really. And where are you from?
East Bentley.
And what's your name?
Kevin Dickens.
Yeah? And do you like Countdown?
Yeah.
Dad object to it?
No.
What about your mum?
No?
What about your dad and mum?
They like it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, listen, I tell you what. I hope your dad and mum like Old 55. Eh?
Yeah.
Do they like them? They sort of groove around a bit? Because I tell you what, the first time we ever had Old 55 on, can you remember the song that we had with Old 55, the first time on Countdown? No? It was On the Prowl. Let's have a look at Old 55, the first time on Countdown was On the Prowl.
So I ran for the stairs, prowling with the boys, and a Saturday.
Right, now listen, Kathy, what do you think of FJ? Here's Grouse. Well, listen, I'll tell you what, we're about to go to the Sydney studios where FJ is. FJ, take it away.
Yeah!
Ah. There they were. Come on, let's do it, Old 55. Now listen. Now listen and listen and listen. With the 100th show, we've got so many directors going on. We've got Rob Weeks, an Australian director up in Sydney, right? Give it, come on, a cheer. We've got our own Ace Drain down here in Melbourne.
How many Ace?
Yeah. Come on, cheer. We've got Bruce Gowers, who did the Queen film clip. He did the Rod Stewart film clip during the London show. And we've all got also got Mike Mansfield up in Scotland. So there you go. Woo! And talking about Scotland, would you believe this kid's from Scotland? Glasgow, Glasgow. But what does Edinburgh mean?
Nothing.
The Rollers. Right, let's go to the Rollers in Edinburgh.
This. Countdown photograph. So it just shows you how popular your show is over in Australia. We found this photograph in Germany in a Bravo magazine. And what have you got to say, Eric?
I was just going to say, congratulations Countdown on the 100th show.
And
we've been coming to Countdown for about the last 3 years now. And we've always been treated good and nice set of guys, Ian, John Paul Young.
But what about the girls?
And everyone else.
What about the girls?
And the, oh well, what can you say about
the
girls?
Tell them about the girls.
But just say it's, we're really proud to be associated with Countdown.
Okay, Squeak.
Yes, mate.
How are you, mate?
I'm fine.
How do you feel like being on the 100th show of Countdown?
I feel really good, mate. That's really nice.
Oh, that's nice. Squeak. Yes. Who feels that I've been nice to the Squeak over the last... You're joking. I'm being a snob to him. Oh. Hold on. As Paul Hogan would say, just the style, hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on. Hold on. Quiet, quiet. One group we should be very proud of.
Yes.
No. Quiet! No, one group we should be very proud of because, just give us a go. One group we should be very proud of is LRB, Little River Band.
Yay!
I've been to London and to America over the last 3 weeks and everyone is raving about them, both in both countries. Let's have a look at... No, I'm not lying. The first time we introduced this group to Countdown was with Curiosity Killed the Cat. Let's have a look at that.
Open your eyes and look around.
A Okay, there was a group that went to into the top 20, the first time a group in Australia has ever gone to the top 20 in America. And I tell you what, this one that's coming up, which is their new single, is going to go to number one in America, number one in Australia, and number one in England. If they don't, then I'll give up everything. Here is LRB with Help Is On Its Way. Oh, and that was written by my little mate Glenn Shorrock, and that is going to be one of the best singles of the year, believe me. Now listen, we're very sneaky. I've got to tell you about this all next week, but just have a look at what we had to do with David Bowie. It's dark, but here is David Bowie. Have a look at this. Oh! Would you believe? Hold on, we finally hit in the toilet after all of that, but I tell you what, watch out for the next countdowns because you're going to see a lot of David Bowie and Iggy Pop. But meanwhile, while the natives are getting restless, let's go back to London with Leo. Leo, take it over, please. All right, thanks, Leo. That was AC/DC. Incidentally, AC/DC, all the press you read about, you know, the Sex Pistols, all of that. I tell you what, AC/DC is slaughtering them in London, so, like, over and above anyone else. So I tell you what, AC/DC, above anyone else, and Paul Hogan, eat your heart out, because this is true, is going to sort of top the charts in the very near future. And that was Dog Eats Dog. Thanks, Leo. Now listen here, little boy.
Yes, mate.
You were telling me a story about Swan Hill, right? When I rang you in Swan Hill, I said, what the hell are you doing in Swan Hill?
Yeah, right. You should be in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And I said, well, no, they'll give me
I was talking about true talent.
Yeah.
Right, now one...
Speaking of Swan Hill...
No, speaking about true talent, one true talent that's been over to America, back again, over to America and back again, and I'll tell you what, America loves her already, is Renee Geyer.
I'm
and the
doing
first
right.
time... The first time we had Renee Geyer on Countdown was If Loving You Is Wrong. Let's have a look at that first. The worst part about it is, apart from Renee having that talent, is that you can rehearse the show and rehearse the show. Once you bring the audience in, it is complete bedlam.
Yeah, I know.
Every week, 100th show, 50th show, I tell you what, it's complete bedlam once you bring the audience in. But talking about really true talent, and I think this is one of the best things she's ever done in her life, the most beautiful lady I know, and she's Hungarian, I believe. Speak Hungarian, speak Hungarian. Here is Renee Geyer with her beautiful single, Stairs and Whispers. Yeah. Renee Geyer! There you go, Countdown's 100th show, and I'll tell you what, that's the first time ever in the world anyone has ever seen on television Leo Sayer singing that song, because we're the only ones that ever taped it. Hey! Look at you. Are you really Hungarian? I beg your pardon?
I don't
know. Well, I'll tell you what, that leads me into the next thing. Do you like it both ways?
My mother's not watching. I like it many ways.
Forget some other way. Okay, the first time we ever introduced a group from Perth, they were Supernaut with I Like It Both Ways. This is how we first saw Supernaut. Right, now squeak. You've never done that.
What?
Being young and innocent.
No, I haven't, have I?
Right. From I Like It Both Ways, Supernaut with in center stage with their new single, Young and Innocent. Here we go. Right, now listen, I'll tell you what. Now it's the 100th show. We've got to admit a few things, right? Now this is Petra from ABC Makeup. Come on. Hey! Because some of us pop stars, this one here in particular, right, has a heavy night, right? And it's Petra and all the makeup crew that make them sort of like, they all look like, oh, like this sort of thing. And Petra seems to make them like this. Dust. You see, I mean, not, actually she shouldn't do it to me because no matter what she does, I mean, I always look the same.
That is real dust coming off his face, by the way.
I beg your pardon?
He's been lying around for so long.
Now, Ted, I'm lost without you. Now, Ted is another one. Ah!
Brian Ferry interview.
Throw to the Brian Ferry interview. Now, listen, we were very lucky. Petra, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I'm welcoming in. I'll tell you what, I'm very welcome in because, I mean, like, that's the one that makes it all together.
Come on, get it.
Well,
get
have you ever thanked Petra?
Yes, I have.
Well, thank Petra.
I haven't done anything.
Say thank you, Petra.
Haven't you done my nose?
I tell you what, you should. Meanwhile, while Petra is doing Squeak's nose, I'll introduce the Brian Ferry interview, which we had a very lucky time to get. Yes! Let's have a look at the Brian Ferry interview.
Hi everybody, this is John English and I'm very proud to have been associated with a great show like Countdown over the last 100 shows. Congratulations to the crew, congratulations to Ian Meldrum and most of all congratulations to yourselves, the viewers, for keeping a world-class pop show on the air.
Well, there you go. Now listen, we've had many audiences in this Countdown thing on the 100th show, right? And I keep reading in all the television magazines, you know, you don't like Squeak, you know, like, what are you doing to Squeak, you know, like, and everything else like that. Yeah. Now, Squeak, on behalf of not only yourself and all your fans, but Sherbet, you name it, here it is, punch me in the nose. I'm inviting you to. A left hook, come on. Oh. Right, from all the ladies, I want you to slap me in the face. Oh. Right, from the Countdown 100th show, and I'm sure there's one guy who, you know, boozes a little, tastes a little. No, not Daryl. Is TMG. And the first time we saw them on Countdown was with Jump In My Car. Did you jump in your car?
Jump in my car. I wanna take you home. Jump in my car. It's too far to walk
away. I feel like Sylvester Stallone, whatever his name is, from Rocky. Anyway, we can better not look at us. How dare you? Anyway, listen, that was TMG back in 2 years ago. Here he is and his band taking the charts by storm over the last 2 years. Do you like TMG?
Yeah.
Yes! Here they are with Jamaica Rum, TMG. Ooh. I tell you what, they're coming from left, right and centre. Now listen, I just want to explain to you one thing. We have received so many telegrams. Hold on, quiet! Hey! Quiet! Now listen, we've received so many telegrams, nothing is working to order. We've got to fit into 90 minutes. Now we've received so many telegrams from Paul and Linda, John Miles, oh you name it, Bob Seger, Peter Frampton, all of them, right? But the most important telegram comes from a viewer, right? And there it is, and it comes from Happy 100th Birthday Show, Countdown, Keep On Rocking, Love. Where is it from? Caroline and Carmel. Right.
From Brunswick.
And they even give us a bottle of champagne, right? But meanwhile, hold on. Hey. Meanwhile, over on centre stage again, is a guy that put the florist business into business, is Mark Holden. And the first time we saw him was Never Gonna Fall In Love Again. Mark Holden. There he was in braces and bare chest. And from the 50th show, he became a great actor, a great songwriter, a great singer. He also became the most successful florist ever. And it was like, you know, with the carnations. But here is Mark Holden with his new single, Hey My Love. Mark Hector Molly. I mean, I've got no choice anymore. What's your name?
Shelley,
where are you from?
Bendigo.
Bendigo, where are you from?
Nagambi.
That's not used to living in Nagambi. Yeah, well, all right. Where are you from?
Brighton.
Where are you from?
Bendigo.
Now listen, I tell you what, every time that I read in the papers, they say, you know, like, shush, like, but let's see what they ask.
From Margaret.
Hi, Garth from Margaret. Right, while this is going on, we were in London and
we happened to go into Abbey Road Studios and we happened to talk to Paul and Linda McCartney from Wings. Let's have a look at it. Over to Paul McCartney. Well, all right, listen. All right. This is the Countdown 100 show. Let's go to Eric in Scotland. Please, please.
Ian, glad to see you get back to Australia, OK? Don't know how he does it. And right now, we're going to hand you down to the London studios, where we've got Susie Quattro. This song's a big hit in Australia, and it's in the charts in Britain, and it's called Tear Me Apart.
Oh, Leo, you don't know how lucky you are. Now, listen, what do you want to say?
Margaret's.
Right, you?
I'm Luella's Dale and Olaf Shirley.
Right, you?
Margaret's Olaf Eric.
Garth and Colin Wells.
You?
Hi to all the kids from St. Leonard's.
You?
All the Flat kids and Bendigo kids.
And you?
To all the noise kids at the dropping centre.
Right, and all of you? Right, while we're doing all of that, let's give an Australian tribute to all of the acts that can't be on tonight, because we've got only 90 minutes. And the first one is a lady who's very sick in hospital, is Marsha Hines. Come on, Marsha Hines. All right. Now, sherbet. What does that mean to you? Oh, no. Garth? Alan? Tony? Right. The first time we were ever, ever really, really proud of sherbet on an overseas level was with How's That? Let's have a look at How's That? Yeah!
Even though you're really not my style, I didn't think that you'd run me round like you do.
From number 2 in England, from number 49 in America, we had the lead singer, Daryl Braithwaite, with his new single, Love Has No Pride. Daryl Braithwaite.